Hi everybody, welcome back. In today's video, we are going to make an awesome STEM project. And of course, STEM is science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. And in this STEM project, we are going to make a pool noodle rocket. Now it is springtime, so it's not quite warm enough to take your actual pool noodle out to the pool. So we're going to use an extra pool noodle today to make this awesome rocket. And yes, it does fly. But you're going to need a few materials. You're going to need some rubber bands of different sizes. You're going to need some duct tape. Now I have fancy duct tape, but you don't need fancy duct tape. It can be regular duct tape as well. You are going to need a fin template. And a fin is what goes on the side of your rocket. I just made this one on a piece of paper. You're going to need some fun foam, which looks like this, or you can use cardstock or cardboard as well. You're going to need something to measure with. A ruler works great. A pair of scissors. Something to mark with. I have a pencil. A skewer. And something to cut with. So parents, make sure we're being very careful with our cutting implement. And of course, a pool noodle. Let's get started. So let's start first by measuring and cutting out our templates. So here's some foam. And here is our template. I made this template just on a piece of paper. I was looking at fins online and I liked the shape of this one. So I kind of just held up my little thin piece of paper to my computer screen and traced it that way. And that works just fine. So you can also design your own, but when you make your fins, you do want to make sure that they are straight. So using a straight edge like a ruler is going to really help you out. The straighter your fins are, the more even your flight pattern. All right, now that we have our three fins, it is time to cut out the length of pool noodle for our rocket. So we need our pool noodle, of course, and our measuring implement, and also a cutting implement. So if you are younger, you certainly probably need help with this step because this is the sharpest part of this project. But as long as you're careful, you should be okay. So what you want is a full foot long piece. So that, of course, I'm making it on camera here, is 12 inches, which is 1 foot. So you can measure it out like that, hold it on the end. And then you're going to take your cutting implement and very carefully score it. So a score just means a little mark like that. And then holding the pool noodle very firmly in one hand and your cutting implement very carefully in the other hand, you're going to find the score, which is right there, and you are just going to push through the foam. Now, like I said, if you need help with this part, certainly get help from an adult, but all you're going to do is push through your little foam noodle, all right? And then you can put that to the side so it is out of the way and safe, and then you have a foot-long piece of noodle. The next thing we need to do is attach our fins, which we just cut out, to our pool noodle, all right? Now in our example over here, you can see they're attached with colorful duct tape. And like I said, you can use colorful duct tape if you have it, but you certainly don't need it. You can use regular old duct tape as well. Now you can decide to have your fins up here, maybe, or down here, but I would recommend a nice even way like this. It's kind of in the middle. There's a little bit of a gap here for your tape. And it kind of just sits like that. That's what I would recommend, but you can certainly try out different things as you experiment. So we are going to attach these with our tape. So when you get your tape, you're going to want to get a piece that is the same length as the edge of your fin. So you can measure it with your little fin, and it's going to be about that length right there. Now you can rip it, but I like to cut it so I have nice, neat edges. But like I said, ripping it works just the same. So to attach your first fin, like I said, it's pretty easy because You don't have to measure, you don't have to guess where the other fins go. So the way I found it to be easiest is to actually attach half of your tape on one side of your fin and make sure you find the edge that goes along the rocket, which is this edge, and you attach it just like that, all right? So about half on the fin and half off the fin. And the half that's off the fin, of course, goes onto your rocket. Now you notice that my fin is not standing up, and that is okay, because the best way to get this attached is to lay it flat and squish it down nice and tight. Now, because this is duct tape and this is foam, if you need to adjust a fin, it's pretty easy. You can just pull it up, all right? But it does stick down if you push it down pretty hard. So for the other half, we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna do our little measure here to make sure we have it about the length we need it. And cut it or rip it. Now to attach the other piece of tape, the easiest way is to lay it down the other way. So what I mean is just literally push your fin over like that, all right? It won't hurt it, and you see it pops right back into place. So to make sure that your tape goes on there nice and snug, you want to push down the fin. And again, you want it to be half on the fin and half on the noodle. So you're gonna push it like that, and if you have a little piece, you can tuck it away. And then you'll notice that you're able to stand it up just like that, you see? So laying it down doesn't hurt it. In fact, it makes sure that your tape goes on there nice and evenly, like you can see. All right, let's attach the other two fins. Now the next part is the last part, and I think it's kind of the toughest, which is why I waited till the end. But now we have to attach our rubber bands. So, of course, when a real rocket flies, it has jet fuel for propulsion, but we don't have jet fuel, so we are going to use rubber bands. So there's only two rubber bands here, and I'm going to explain how to attach them, but I want you to look in there and kind of see how it's anchored and how it's anchored on the outside before we get started here. So let's pull out our noodle, and at this point you have to decide what tool you're going to use. Do you want to use a skewer? Do you want to use a pencil? First thing you need to do is poke a hole to anchor your first rubber band. So for that I like to use a skewer. You can use a pencil as well. You just want to make sure that it will go all the way through, so you kind of measure by going like that. All right, so I'm going to use a skewer, and I'm going to go about an inch down. So what that looks like is about like that. All right, so that's where I'm going to poke my hole. So you're going to kind of just wiggle it through there. There you go. And then once it's through, once it's in the middle, you can kind of feel it. And then you want to pause and line it up so it goes all the way through the other side evenly. So if you take a look in there, if you can see, there you go. It looks pretty even. I might straighten it up just a little bit, and then I'm going to push it through to the other side, okay? So I just push my noodle, or my stick through, and then you have a stick and a full noodle, okay? So this next part is pretty tricky. So I would recommend using a larger rubber band. This is like a double size rubber band, whereas this is kind of a regular size. Either work, but sometimes this part is a little bit easier with a longer rubber band. So I'll show you how it's gonna work next. So the next part is pulling your stick or your pencil back out, and then kind of attaching it to the tool that you've used, and you're going to put it back in. So you're gonna, I slipped it over this, and I'm just going to stick it back in here. And this is where it gets tricky, because the rubber band doesn't want to stay on the stick. So it wants to fall off, but that's okay. We're gonna do our best to push it through there. All right, and we're gonna push it back through. And our goal is to get our rubber band through our little noodle here. So sometimes it takes a little while. You have to coax it in there like that, but you can see it's kind of poking through. Whoop, and then you can sometimes grab it, which is super helpful. And you're gonna push it through the other hole that you made as well, okay? And this is where it gets tricky, because it doesn't really want to go in there. So you kind of just have to play with it a little bit. There we go. And eventually, you should be able to get your rubber band through both sides. Yay, there it is. All right, and you grab a hold of it. Now this is very important. You don't want to pull it out one side or the other because then you have to start over. So what I might do is take one of my tools and stick it through one of the sides. So if I do accidentally pull it, it doesn't pull all the way through. Okay? So the next part is kind of tricky. So go ahead and watch. You are going to take one side of your rubber band and put it over the top. Okay? So I'm going to do that again. It's just like this, and it goes over the top, all right? And then you're gonna let it go so it's like attached to it, all right? Then you're gonna come over to your other side, and hopefully you haven't lost it inside your pool noodle. You can take your little tool off there. And you're going to do the same thing, but on the other side, okay? So I'm just taking it over the top and looping it around, you see? So again, just taking this over the top and loop it around, all right? So it looks like it's wearing a rubber band, but we know that we have attached it, we have anchored it on the inside, okay? So you have your rubber band all the way through the middle of your noodle and attached on the outer sides, okay? Now the next part also involves a rubber band. So you're gonna pick the rubber band that you like, all right? This is a regular size one, it's not a double size one, just a regular old rubber band. And you have to anchor it on the inside of your pool noodle. So our example here, you can see how it's just kind of, I think that's called a hitch knot. It's just wrapped around the middle. All right, and that's what we're gonna do with this as well. So this is tricky. It helps if you have smaller fingers. So if you have small fingers, this is the job for you. But even big adult fingers like mine can do it, all right? So you're gonna put it over the end of your finger like this, and you're going to loop it around the back side of your rubber band on the inside, all right? So you see how I pushed it through, and it kind of helps if you pull it up too. So that's what it looks like, all right? And then one side is going to go through the other side, all right? Just like that. And then you're gonna give it a nice tight tug, just like that. And you have a completed pool noodle rocket, all right? Now, some people like to take a piece of duct tape and cover their rubber bands, which I think is a good idea because it's foam, those rubber bands kind of get a little bit tight after a while, and you don't want it to pull through, you don't want the rubber bands to pull through. So if you give it a little bit of extra help, it won't try and break on you, okay? So they just go over the top like this, and this actually kind of, I think, neatens up your rocket and makes it look complete, right? Now, most rockets have a nose cone. Again, this isn't a real rocket. You don't have jet fuel or anything like that, so you don't have a nose cone, but you do have the body of the rocket. You have fins that are on there, hopefully pretty straight, and you have a completed rocket. So the next thing to do is take it outside and give it a try. Welcome to my backyard. So we have our two pool noodles here, and we're gonna launch the first one just to show you how it flies, and then I will teach you how to launch the next one, all right? So let's give it a try. Whoops, well, if it hadn't hit the rose bush, I think it would have been great. All right, so here's the rocket that we made, and this is how you're gonna launch it. With your not dominant hand, so that's my left hand, I'm going to make little pincher fingers. And I'm going to pinch those fingers inside the hole and on the outside, so like that. So I'm just pinching it so I can hold it like this, okay? That is how you hold your rocket back. With the other hand, your dominant hand, you are going to point and you're going to aim, all right? So you want to get your rubber band outside, your launching rubber band from out of inside the rocket, and it is going to be on your pointer finger like this, all right? So you don't want these fingers in the way, because if they bump into those fingers, it's not gonna fly very well. So make sure that the pointer finger on your dominant hand is where you have your rubber band, okay? So I am holding with these two pinched fingers and I am pointing and aiming with this pointer finger, okay? So it'll go this way, all the way. All right, so let's give this a try. And what you're going to do is let go with these fingers. This finger is only for aiming. You're going to just let go with these fingers. Let's give it a try. So let's give it another try. Again, pinching with this with these fingers, pointing and aiming with this finger. And all I'm gonna do is let go with these two fingers. Woo! Let's try it again. Again, pinching here and pointing and aiming with this finger.